If you're using your Mac with an external display and you want to change which one of your displays is going to be the primary display, you can do that very simply by going into System Preferences and navigating to Displays. Here you'll see your display orientation, and across one of those displays you're going to see a white bar at the very top. If you drag that white bar from the one display to your secondary display, you've now changed which display is going to be your primary. Now, if you like that tip, I've got 9 more for you in today's video, so let's get started. What is going on, everybody? My name is Mike. Welcome back to the channel. I'm very glad that you are back with me today because I have 10 tips that are going to make you more productive on your Mac. I have some system preferences we're going to change. I have some app recommendations for you, as well as some keyboard shortcuts. So let's get into the second tip. Now, our second tip is making sure that you have good hygiene on your desktop and with screenshots. And I'm going to show you a way to change the default file format for all the screenshots that you take, and also how to clean up your desktop so you don't have that cluttered mess of screenshots there. You can go right into Terminal and type in this terminal command that you're showing right here on my screen and append JPG or JPEG at the end of it, and it's going to change the default file type from PNG to JPEG. Now, if you don't like that and you want to change it back, you just go ahead and type in that same terminal command and put PNG at the end. You'll be right back to where you started. If you don't know, when you take a screenshot, it does save that file as a PNG, which tends to be high fidelity, and it's going to be a larger file size. This is going to save you about 75% on screenshots, so any amount of storage that you can save is a good one. Now here, I'm going to open up my movies folder, and here I have a movie. Well, if I click on open, what does it do? It opens up with the Apple TV app. That's not what I want. All right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on open with, and I'm going to change the default, and I'm going to change it to QuickTime, but also I can even do it another way. I'm going to click on Command I, which is going to show the inspector window. If I go down to the very bottom where it says open with, I'm going to click on this window here. I can change it to any app that I want to here, and then click on always or change all. So every app that has this M4V file extension will always open up with QuickTime. Now, this next tip that I have here is going to be about navigation. It's really going to show you how to be, you know, super efficient on your Mac using just a few different keyboard shortcuts. So we're going to open up Finder, and I'm going to do that by hitting Option and open up my Finder window. And I have the Finder window open. Now, first thing is that if you want to bring any window into full screen, you're going to hit Control Command F, and that brings it into full screen, and the same set of keys, Control Command F, to bring it out of full screen. Now, if you want to change from this folder view to list view to column view to gallery view, you hit Command and number 1, number 2, number 3, or number 4 to change your view there. Now, what I'm going to do next is customize my sidebar. My sidebar here, I'm going to click on Finder, I'm going to go to Preferences, and here I have Hard Disk Disabled and Connected Server Disabled. I don't want to see these on the desktop. That's just to me is annoying. If I open up a new Finder window, I want that new Finder window to start in the Movies folder, because for me, that's where I'm working in the majority of the time when I'm on my computer. And I want to open folders in new tabs opposed to opening up in new windows. So whether I hit Command T to open up a new tab or Command N to open up a new window, if I already have the app open, it's going to open up in a new tab. Now, next, I'm going to go to Tags, and I have Tags disabled because I don't ever use Tags. And if you use Tags, let me know that. I would love to know how you use them because I'm trying to be productive and use them, but I just really never find a good way. Now, let's go to Sidebar here. In the Sidebar, I turned off Recent because I don't know why that's ever turned on. I never want to see Recents, and I have on my Mac turned off. I show these folders on my iCloud Drive, and I have these locations shown here in the location side. Now, if you want to copy everything down, you certainly can go ahead. And now if I go to the Advanced tab, I'm going to turn off Show All File Name Extensions. I don't want to see the file extension. If I want to, I can always click on a file and click Command I to show the file name extension if I wanted to. Otherwise, I don't really need to see it. I also have turned on Keep Folders on Top in Windows when sorting by name and on desktop. So what that means is if I have this unchecked, it sorts everything that's in the folder alphabetically, including the file, which is not the same, opposed to having the file at the end of all the folders. This to me is the most meaningful way to have this information sorted for here. Now, additionally, I have, when performing a search, search the current folder, because anytime that you're doing a search, you're probably already in the folder or in one of the folders that you need to have enabled for that search. So I already searched the current folder. I don't want to turn on Search This Mac because that, to me, is just useless. It takes too much time. Now, a couple other things that I have turned on, I go to View and I click on Show Path Bar and Show Status Bar. That's this information here. The path bar is what the path that you took to get to the folder that you're in, and the status bar is how much is what is in the folder and how much storage is going to be available on that. Now, what you can easily do if you didn't want to navigate between this folder and let's say we're going to go down a couple levels here. I'm going to go here and here, and if I didn't want to go to the column view by hitting Command 3, I'm going to stay in Command 1, and I'm just going to actually click here along the bottom. I'm going to go back to Movies. So it's very easy to navigate once you turn on the path bar. In my opinion, it's probably the better way to navigate opposed to clicking back and forth. Now, if you wanted to just close this one window, you can hit Command W. That's going to close this window. And you can hit Command W and then Command W again to get rid of those windows. I haven't found a way to close all the windows in Finder, but if you know one, let me know down in the comments below. Guys, if you're finding value in today's video, meaning I showed you something that you didn't know how to do on the Mac, drop a like down below. Maybe consider even sharing this video with someone who would get benefit from learning these Mac tips, or join and subscribe to the channel where I help other people like you get the most out of their tech. Now let's go on to the next tip. I'm going to open up System Preferences. And in System Preferences, when you want to find something, it never seems to be in the same place or you can't find it. Now, what I would like to do is I'd like to click on View. And I like to organize these alphabetically. That's like to me is a game changer because it's in the order that makes most sense for me. But now let's just say that you aren't that person and this still makes sense to you while you do it in categories. Well, if you want to, you could then click on Customize. And here you see all these check marks appear next to these apps. So maybe you never want to see Siri. Maybe you never want to see Energy Saver. You could take off Time Machine and you can click Save or turn off Customize. And then that app is removed from the System Preferences. Now it's not deleted, it's just you took that app out of System Preferences and you could still access it here from the list if you wanted to, or you can go back to Customize and then it gives you the ability to add it back to that by adding the check mark. So that's another nice thing I like to go ahead and do. But while we're here in System Preferences, let's take a look at Dock and Menu Bar. Now you can get to the System Preferences for Dock and Menu Bar a few different ways. You can open up System Preferences by opening up Alfred or in Spotlight. Here in the top left-hand corner, go to System Preferences. But you can also bring up the menu bar by right-clicking here on this line, and then you can actually bring up Dock's Preferences. Now for me, this might be controversial here, but my Dock and Menu Bar, I have it a medium size. I don't turn on magnification. I like having it located in the bottom because this is going to give me the most screen real estate. I do have two displays. And if I were not using it on, if I was using it on my MacBook, I would have it turned on the right-hand side so it shows here. But I think it makes most sense for most people on the bottom. And I have it turning the zoom turned on. And I have automatically hide and show the menu bar on desktop and in full screen disabled. If I go to Control Center here, I have all these things are actually turned on minus Spotlight Search. I have that. It should be turned off. Is turned off as well. Now, one thing if you wanted to do, let's just say you want to have this in the menu bar and you want to have the mic mode, or let's say you want to have your focus mode and it's not currently there, you can actually click on this and drag it to the menu bar and it actually will place it there for you. Now, speaking of the menu bar, I use an app called Bartender. This is something that organizes the apps that are in your menu bar and you can only show and you can limit what you show in the menu bar. I only have a couple things showing in there. This is 1Password, which is the password manager of choice that I use. CleanShot X, which I'm going to talk about here next. Magnet, which I'll talk about in a few minutes. And then the app that I use to monitor my system resources. Now that we've organized the dock and the menu bar, let's talk about optionality. Now, option is probably the most powerful key on the Mac because when you hit option along with like maybe a right click, it's going to give you more contextual options than you had before. For example, if you are working in an app like Safari because it supports multiple windows, multiple tabs, and you want to close the app because it's really just taking up real estate or it's minimizing the dock, but you don't want to lose your place and you definitely don't want to create a, like a browser tab group, here is an option that is going to blow your mind. You go to open up an app and instead of hitting Command Q to quit the app, if you hit Command Option Q, you get the ability to keep the windows open. This works on messages, it works on browsers, it works on anything that supports multiple tabs or multiple windows other than Finder. Wait, what? Hold on a second here. So yes, it's going to open up Safari with all the tab groups that you have open, all the different tabs or all the different browser windows that you have open, just like it was never closed. This is a game changer for me because I like to keep Safari open like in the background while I'm doing research and not necessarily close it, but now I don't have to worry about that because when I hit Option Command Q to close Safari, it does retain all the settings that I had and all the different browser windows that I had open, it's a game changer for me. If I click on, say, this folder here, my template folder, if I hold down Option and then drag with this, it creates a duplicate. If I were to click on the Finder window or go down to my dock and look at any one of these apps that I have open, if I right-click on it, the first option is Quit. Well, if I click Option, I get the ability to force quit the app. I want to click on Wi-Fi. Well, here, if you click on Wi-Fi, there's obviously not a lot of information. It's not very helpful. Well, if I Command and click here, I get to see everything about my network. I get to see the network name, the IP address, the router IP address, what type of security I'm using, all these cool things, including the signal strength of my Wi-Fi network and the noise floor. So you can see a lot of things on here and it tells you a lot of information, but this also works as well with Bluetooth. I get all the information about my Bluetooth peripherals that are not just connected, but that have been connected. So I get the device name, the role that it plays, the MAC address, the battery level, the firmware level, a whole bunch of stuff that is not available. And this also works actually in displays. If you look here, there are typically 5 settings for the display that you can choose from if you're running your display in scaled. Let's assume it supports scaled. Well, if I click on default and then click on option and click on scaled, I now get the whole breadth of monitor options that are available here. So I could choose to run it in any configuration or in any resolution that I want to. Default, and then click on scaled with option held down. Now this next app is, I live and die by because I take so many screenshots with my computer, not just because I like memes or anything like that, but I use it for documentation when I'm creating documentation for work, Teams chat, I just use it a lot. And so it is a necessity for me. Now the default or the built-in screenshot app from Apple, from macOS, is good, but CleanShotX, which is a third-party app, is like way better. It's $29 for the app itself if you buy it through CleanShotX, the developer, or I think you can get it in setup as well. This is an app that allows you really to fine-tune and dial in the way that you take screenshots. I can click on the screenshot, I can annotate it if I want to, I can take the screenshot and then get a shareable link. I can record my screen. I can use OCR. The OCR thing is so crazy. Let's see this one in action because it's kind of hard to believe. I'm gonna click on OCR and I'm gonna do this area right here. And what it did was it took this file, the name in there, and if I do this, paste it, it actually OCRs the text from the screenshot, which is really amazing. If you take screenshots or you do screen recordings, I would definitely suggest checking it out because for me, it's a game changer. Guys, thanks very much for watching my video on 10 Mac tips to make you more productive. Now, I hope you enjoyed it. If you have a tip that I didn't talk about, let me know down in the comments below. Maybe I can implement it in my workflow. I love being productive on my Mac and on my iPad as well. And to that note, I will put some playlists right around here somewhere to help you be more productive on your Mac. I'll talk to you in the next one.